those who haven't seen, this is how one attaches a bat to a wheel. So, small amount of plate, centred. Like the lemon, really. Hold in the middle, and then you just pull this ring out.
Shorten your nails as you go in.
Yeah.
So that's what, about a pound of clay, thereabouts?
Probably a bit less. So that then takes it, but you can get underneath here to lift it off. And because it's a ring of clay, it's often when you lift that off, it's slightly dead in that, but you can then very quickly just recenter it as a ring. By recentering, you made it wet so the bat then sticks to it. All right.
How did bats come to be called bats? Because they don't look anything like a bat.
Yeah, because those big ones, you know, under that table there, they're called bucklers. So you just put a little bit of a wiggle and it should be in place. Doesn't matter what bat's doing, doesn't matter what bat's doing, because I know this is your bat's doing that. It doesn't, for what you're doing, it doesn't matter because your throw comes off the top and you've centered that. But if you were to make a bowl on that, when you took it off the bat and sat it down, it would be uneven.
Sorry about that.
Okay.
Well, just take the whole bat off and get Douglas to
do
a new one.
You know, I have it so it's a bit under the bat like that, so I can use a block of wood like that, you know, just to prise it off.
Right.
Okay.
So,
and then if you're making really big flat dishes, and you're going to have a bat that's bigger than the wheel, it's then very easy to have that just a little bit tore up, and so the bat is out here. Right.
And then it's getting off because you've got the overhand leverage.
Yeah, well, you know, it's a twisting action then that takes it off, and so you can reset that.
Right.
Okay.
Sorry.
I'm not saying anything.
You better not.
So, going a bit further, several of you asking me about colouring things in.